The tiny ant leaves his tiny ant drops in the sand and makes his home inside a rusty watering can. Occasionally going out to look for bread and jam. He runs into a sparrow who hasn't eaten for a week. And later, quite contented, the sparrow cleans his beak, failing to notice pussycat has come out to take a leak. Our cat partakes of dinner when a sudden kangaroo emerges from the undergrowth and asks to use the loo. Kangaroos aren't usually dangerous, for that would never do. My goodness, will you look at all the animals queuing on the stairs? Look at the animals in the zoo, how would you like to be one? They're waiting to use the lavatory and putting chewing gum in each other's hair. Look at the animals, look at you. Flying from the chandeliers and treading in their elephantine stools. Look at the animals two by two, aren't you glad to be one? This kangaroo's a lunatic and his pouch is very full of pussycats and penguins who can't fly as a rule. But then neither could the pussycat, he never went to school. The kangaroo gets nervous when confronted by the size of an elephant named Simon, who is always telling lies. He swears he wears green corduroys and can button up his fly. Presently a fatter Simon's indigestion fails. He regurgitates the whole damn mess into an aluminium pail. And the tiny ant scuttles back inside his watering can, occasionally going out to look for bread and jam.
Woof, woof, woof.
Thank you. The tiger flashes sharpened teeth. Bowler-hatted summer briefs beneath his pinstripe skin. To kill demands a business sense. Economy moves non-residents approaching from downwind. Being a tiger means you laugh whenever lesser tigers have to eat meat that's infected. Being a tiger means you mate when overfed will defecate in places least expected. A tiger means you must accept his promise of mutual trust and offer him your throat. Loving a tiger means you take second place to the cake you bake and with undying servile obedience keep the stiffly starched collar of his conference shirt spotless and remove daily the daubed bloody evidence of his dastardly misdeeds from the otherwise immaculate elegance of his pinstripe tiger coat. Period.
Hello, this is Law of the Bungle, part 2. By the way, I'm Martin Barr, but sometimes I'm an owl, and my feathers are really smooth, and when I feel romantic, I like to dress up in men's clothing.